Hello friends, welcome to this session on the projection of triangular prism and myself Dr. M.S. Chennaiah, Professor of Mechanical Engineering and Vice Principal at Saptagiri College of Engineering, Bangalore. So in the second, the problem you have got here is again a problem on the triangular prism resting on one of its longer edges. So this is the prism you have got, which has got shorter sides measuring 25 mm each, height of the solid or height of the longer edge is 60 mm, and it has rest on HP on one of its longer edges. Friends, remember, similar to our pyramids, if the object has to rest on one of the longer edges, one of the corner of the solid should come to the right side of the observer. So here, friends, I am going to place the object on HP such that one of the corner, that is A1, will come to the right side of the observer and obtain the top view and front view of the object. So here the top view is going to be a triangle and the front view is going to be a rectangle, with one of the corner coming to the right side and the shorter edge opposite to that is perpendicular to the wall. So now I am going to write the xy line mark V3HP, indicating the first angle projection. This is the xy line we have got, and this is y we have got here, and it has to rest on one of these slanted longer edges here, given here, and longer edge. Longer edge is what? This is AA1 or VB1, CC1, any of these. So I just write down the top view. An equilateral triangle having side, shorter side measuring 25 mm and obtain the corresponding front view. A rectangle whose height is given to be 60 mm. Mark the center of the solid by bisecting any two adjacent sides. Call this as O, O1. Mark O', O1', the height of the axis or the length of the axis equal to 60 mm. Given the problem, so this is going to be 60 mm. So we have the front view and top view, where one of the corner of this solid is to the right side of the observer and the opposite edge is perpendicular to VP. So, I will teach you a very simple method of marking the solid. See, you start from the top view. I will mark like this. Please observe. This is A, B, C. So, if A, B, C are the three corners, here just mark it as A dash, B dash, because A and B are this line. This will become C dash. So, first you mark in the top view, come to the front view, mark at the top A, B, C. Show the same thing with 1. So this is going to be A1 dash, this is B1 dash, this is O1 dash, O dash, and this is C dash with 1, C1 dash. Here double marking A1, BB1, CC1, where these A1, B1, C1 are not visible. You can show them inside the bracket. It is only a convention followed, and even if you don't mark also, there is nothing wrong. Friends, I have obtained the front view and top view of the prism when resting on its triangular face A1, B1, C1 and HP. Let us see the terminology of this front view. In the front view, friends, you can see the extreme right hand line is C' C1' dash. It represents one of the longer edges like our A' A1' dash, B' B1' dash, because the triangular prism has got three longer edges. Now he says this has to rest on one of the longer edges. The longer edge is C' C1' dash here. So now that longer edge is perpendicular to the HP. I will say it is one of the longer edges. Longer edge, and that edge is perpendicular to HP. Perpendicular to HP. He says it has to rest on that. Let's call this figure as figure number 1. where the object is resting on one of the triangular faces on HP with longer edge perpendicular to it. Now, I have to redraw this figure 1 such that this longer edge represented by C dash C1 dash rests on the XY line. So, anywhere on this, I am going to redraw this figure 1 taking the same height, the axis length 60 mm. I am going to redraw the figure here and mark all these points. The figure was like this, it is drawn like this. So, uppermost point will be A dash B dash, bottom is C dash. For the bottom one, go in the same order. This is A1 dash, B1 dash, this is C1 dash. Axis as usual, near to that AB it will be. So, it will come somewhere here, dash dot. This represents the axis and the measurement of the axis is taken from here, here. And you have marked that. You call this as O dash and O1 dash. Friends, we will name this as figure number 2. And remember, figure number 1 and 2 are identical. And here, the object is resting on C dash, C1 dash. And C dash, C1 dash represents one of the longer edges. So, I will say one of the longer edge on HP. One of the longer edges on HP. So, this is the front view in the second position. Let me get all these points for the top face and also for the bottom face. So, let us start with the point A. Vertical line from A, horizontal line from A. This point of intersection will give you A. Similarly, B, vertical line from B, horizontal line from here, and you will be getting the point of intersection of these two as B. So, this is point B. Likewise, C, horizontal line from here, vertical line from here. So, they two meet exactly in the center of these that you can have as a sort of check. This is going to be the point C. So, we got ABC. This line represents one of the triangular face. There is a top triangular face. And likewise, you are going to get for the bottom face also equal number of points. That is, this A, in place of A, you will get A1, this is C1, this is B1. And here, the outlines are visible. I mark this A full line, B full line. Listen, your friends, the object is resting on CC, that is the longer edge CC. So, it is just resting like that. So, when it is resting on one of the longer edges, the two triangular faces containing that longer edge are equally inclined to HP. And this slant edge on which the object is resting is not visible to the observer in that top view. Hence, the longer edge CC is shown as a dotted line. This represents the longer edge of the line CC. Mark O and O1, the center of the top and bottom faces. Friends, is it clear? I hope this is all clear to you. Now, we have this CC1 also coinciding with OO, that is, the axis is parallel to VP. He says in the question, such that the plane containing the axis and the longer edge on which it rests is inclined. Friends, if you see the front view in the second position, O dash, O1 dash is the axis, C dash, C1 dash is the longer edge on which the object is resting, and this plane, this rectangle represents the plane containing the axis and the longer edge on which it is standing. So, this rectangle or the plane is seen as a line here, that is both points, C dash, C1 dash, O1 dash, O dash, that is shown in the top view as O, O1, C1, O. This line represents a plane. This plane is now parallel to VP. He says, draw the projections of the solid when this plane is inclined at an angle of 30 degrees to VP. So, what is to be done? Whatever the top view you have got in figure number 2, or you call it as figure number 3, is to be drawn. This figure has to be drawn on a line where the plane represented by this is at an angle of 30 degrees to VP. So I am going to redraw figure number 3 on a line which is inclined at an angle of 30 degrees to VP and get the corresponding print view. So okay, I will just write a line here. The line is inclined at an angle of 30 degrees to VP. On this, I am going to mark this line OC, O1, C1, the same rectangle I am going to construct here. This rectangle is written here. You should know this is 60 mm. Same 60, 60 is again going to be 60. And same reproduction of the previous figure. This figure number 4 will be called. And how to mark them? This figure is drawn this way. I am taking the top face ACB near to the observer. This will be ACB, ACB, and this is O. Likewise for the bottom, A1, exactly center C1, O1, and this point is B1. And get the corresponding print view. Friends, in the final print view, you can observe the top face of the solid ACB or ABC is nearer to the observer, whereas the bottom face of the same solid is nearer to VP or away from the observer. So I am going to start with the surface which is nearer to the observer. So I will get 3 points, one from A, one from C, one from B. So look here friends, A and B lie on this line. So write horizontal here, vertical line from A, horizontal line from A, the point of intersection is A dash. Likewise B, vertical line from here, horizontal line from this point will be view B dash. You have got A dash, B dash, C will come exactly, C is here, horizontal line from C, vertical line from C will come exactly in the center here. This is going to be point C, C dash. So I am going to join all these by visible lines, A dash to B dash, B dash to C dash, C dash to A dash. And as usual, the center of the top page is O, this point is O, or O dash to say correctly. Again, I just told you in the previous session that whatever the figure you get for this face, same identical figure you are going to get for the bottom face also. The bottom face is A1, B1, C1. Follow the procedure and get 3 points. So this is going to be your point A1 dash. This is going to be B1 dash. Center of this is going to be C1 dash. Here C1 dash. This is B1 dash. This is O1 dash. O dash and O1 dash are the center of the bottom and top faces. Now, the figure ABC, A1, B1, C1 you get here is exactly identical to that. So, let me join all the border lines. I will join this CC also. Friends, what is not visible to the observer is this corner A1 of the bottom face. So, when it is not visible, it is not visible here also. So, I show this by a hidden line, a dotted line, indicating that it is not visible to the observer in the print view. I mark the axis, dash, dot, dash, etc. So we have got all the points. Friends, you can observe here. And let us have a check whether the solution you have got satisfies all the requirements of the question. So we will start from here. The object is triangular prism. Now it was meant to rest on one of the triangular faces. We got the top view. In the front view, the long range was represented by the last line C dash C1 dash because it's got only 2 points. The figure number 2 was drawn at the same. One was copied as figure number 2 with the same dimension. Figure number 1 and 2 are the same. Here you can see we made the object to rest on C dash, C1 dash, one of the longer edges of the solid, and this axis became parallel to XY. We got the top view. In the top view, the axis is again parallel. One condition given in the problem is that he says, draw the projections of the solid when the plane containing the axis and the long range on which it stands, that means this plane surface, is normal to HP. So it is normal to HP, that's why it is seen as a line O1C1C that is now parallel to BP, that was redrawn as per the problem, that is to get an angle of 30 degrees to BP, and you have got the front view. In the front view, friends, it is very clear that the triangular prism is resting on C'C1', where C'C1' is one of the longer edges, and also you can observe here, whenever any of these solids rest on the longer edge on HP, the two rectangular faces, that is C', B', B1', C1' is one rectangular face. Similarly, on the other end, C', A', A1', C1' is the other rectangular face. They make equal inclination, say angle alpha with HP. So this is the final front view of the solid, marked as FV, and this is the top view of the solid, marked as TV, and the last two figure will give you the complete solution of the problem. I hope, friends, you're all happy with the presentation, and if you're satisfied with this presentation, and if you feel that is going to be of use to all the students studying engineering graphics, a subject which is common for all the students of first year throughout the world, I can say, you can refer and share it with your friends. Let them also get benefited. And this is Dr. M. H. Anaya signing off.